My name is Dr. Peggy Oti-Boateng. I'm the Director for Science Policy and Capacity Building in the Natural Sciences of UNESCO. I have the pleasure to invite Dr. Maha Dahawi. She holds a doctorate degree in neuroscience from the University of Sorbonne and University of Khartoum. And she's also one of our 2020 Young Talent for Women in Science, Sub-Saharan Africa. Dr. Dahawi, could you please tell us more about your scientific career and your current research?
Thank you very much for having me here today. It's a pleasure for me. I started my journey as a doctor. I graduated from the Faculty of Medicine, University of Khartoum. And then I did my master's in that same university in human physiology. And then I proceeded to do my PhD in genetics of epilepsy in Sudan, because we want to study more about the effect of consanguinity marriages on the epilepsy in our country. Mm. At the same time, I am developing with our lab a new method to functionally validate the genes, the epileptic genes in the worm C. elegans. So I'm working in parallel as a collaboration between the two countries to convey the studies and to translate it and to convey it to my country in Sudan.
Thank you very much. What influenced your interest in taking up this male-dominated STEM field?
So being in science is not an easy choice, but I decided to get enrolled in science since I was very young, because I was diagnosed with a very rare disease, an autoimmune disease that has a major effect on my health. And to be able to deal with the pain of this disease, I started searching how the brain reacts to the pain responses and how our ideas and our thoughts can influence the effect of the pain in our bodies. And this is how I get involved into the neuroscience, the cognitive sciences, and the mind-body connection in influencing this response.
Who inspired you?
I wouldn't say that somebody inspired me. I would say that the impact of the science on our lives is what inspired me the most in this field. And I want to say that women in science are not a lot. We need to speak up to have a more influence of women in impacting the science in our communities. And for that, we developed a pay it forward notion. It's for women in Sudan. And we wanted to convey this message through this platform.
Great, thank you very much. And how has this experience as a woman in science, technology, engineering, mathematics, for short, STEM field, you must have faced some challenges. What are some of these challenges?
So what was challenging for me in the beginning was the idea that I came from a different culture. And in the new culture that I am in, people have preconceived ideas of what to expect from women coming from developing countries like us. And to be able to do this, I started communicating about who we are, what we do, what are our motives, and how we can get the difference in cultures as an enriching platform instead of defining it as a difference. We enrich each other by exchanging communications and by exchanging the different cultures we come from. And I saw that people started to respond positively to the initiative of communicating about who we are and what we are doing. And I saw the positive impact of this communication.
Yeah, so in a way, communication is very, very important.
I think it's vital. We cannot do without.
Yeah, in this case, what is your favorite aspect of this male-dominated neuroscience to share with other young people?
So I am, as I said, I'm interested in behavioral neuroscience. I would say that I will ask ladies, girls, and women like me to dare, because we think that we need to be perfect before starting anything in our lives, and I think this is not true. We are perfect in our imperfections, and we need just to start to take the first step and to go through, and then steps will follow sequentially, and I just ask them to be brave, to follow what they aim for, what their dream is. This is truly what I believe in.
Yeah, thank you. You are really inspiration to, you know, all young people, especially women.
Thank you.
Maha, you were awarded as the Young Talent of the L'Oreal UNESCO for Women in Science, Sub-Saharan Africa. Has this recognition had any impact on your work?
It has a huge impact on my work. I would start by saying that through this opportunity, I developed nationally and internationally my network. And by that, I was able to convey the message I'm conveying now to different nations around the world. And I can see that people are reacting to the notion by supporting, by communicating, by developing new opportunities for women who will come after me. And this is my goal. I want really women from Africa to have the opportunity I had. And I will take any opportunity to communicate about that to make this happen.
Good. Thank you very much, Dr. Dahawi, for sharing your views with us. And I hope it will be an inspiration to many other young women. And also congratulations on your award for the 2020 Young Talent.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure for me to be here. I'm beyond grateful to have this opportunity.
Thank you.